What's going on? Kevin Hart here. We're coming back with season 8 of Cold as Balls. That's right, I said it, and I know what you're thinking. How many more of these are we going to do?
Hey! Oh, oh, I missed. Wait, sorry.
I knew it. I could feel it coming. I felt it coming.
I missed.
As I was right
Hi,
here.
Hi, Kevin.
How are you, Chiney? How you doing?
I'm doing great.
I'm happy for you.
Thank you.
Chiney, I'm pretty pumped up.
Are you? I can't tell.
What do you mean?
I mean, you always are pumped up.
No, not like today. I'm pumped up.
Are you ready for this, though? Because I know you're used to kiddie pools and stuff, so this should be like your lane.
Chiney, get in the damn tub.
I got you.
That's what happens. Ooh. People change. This is a clear example of how people change. Okay?
But honestly, I usually wear the toe thingies though, so like that's what's killing me right now.
Yeah,
you know, like the toe?
Because you're what you call a chump.
Excuse me. You know my reach is great. I can get you from here.
Okay. This is another episode of Coldest Balls, and guess what? We have WNBA great Chiney Ogwumike on the show. Yeah, I said it right.
You nailed it.
And now I can say journalist as well.
Does that make you a journalist too because you do interviews?
First of all, I've been a journalist.
Oh, God.
Okay, I'm a multi-hyphenate. Chiney, we have a lot to talk about, okay? You come from a big family.
Yes.
Right? Four girls, you have four sisters?
Yeah, four girls. I'm number two.
Family from Nigeria, but you grew up in Houston.
Yeah, right? Born and raised in Houston, Texas, but Nigerian-American is what we tell people.
Okay, Nigerian-American is what we tell people.
You know, one of the biggest, I guess you can say, things was trying to figure out how to reconcile your culture. Like, I'm a black woman, but I was born and raised in Houston, Texas. But you know how it is, like, in your house, I'm in an African house.
Mm-hmm.
First generation born and raised here.
First generation born and raised. Do you love when you go back?
Oh my gosh, yeah. And you've been.
I've been.
What was it, Ghana? Where'd you guys go?
First of all, after going to South Africa, I was given a name. My name is Umpo.
Umpo?
Yes, Umpo Hart.
Okay, what does that mean? Like small heart?
See, what you're doing now is asking too many questions. You and your sister.
Played together.
Played together, right? Both went to Stanford.
Yeah.
Both drafted. First, number one?
Yeah.
Let's just hold on to that for a second.
We all are nerds. You know, obviously went to Stan. Oh, hold up. Oh, we got some people hooping. Hooping. Hey.
No.
Do your thing.
Bam.
Do your thing. Hold on, I can help you. We can go here. Oh.
Okay. What are you doing? How the hell do you miss the bucket when it's right in front of you, Bam? Hi. What?
He's just impersonating you on the court.
Okay.
Oh, there we go.
Okay.
Nice. What nice.
Thank you, Bam. Coming out in the jerseys are an amazing gesture. It looks as if you actually have done your research and are aware of our guest today. Thank you for doing your job. Okay? You come out, Bam!
Whoa!
Okay, you know what? Your sister going into the WNBA.
Yeah.
Did it set some fire
Motivate,
off in you?
Inspire. Yes. You know what's actually hilarious? Her senior year, she was like, I'm gonna, after Stanford, go into medical school. I don't know what else I wanna do. Because being Nigerian, it's like doctor, lawyer, engineer, not like number one WNBA draft pick. And so finally, towards the end of like the March Madness run, she's like, oh yeah, like I'm going into the W.
We are talking about the thing that fueled your fire. Just staying on that topic. Let me tell you what fuels mine. It's a swagger anti-perspirant 5-pack.
So, AKA
fire going.
Securing the bag.
No, it's not securing a bag. It's just telling you what I do.
Okay?
I don't even have to pick this one up. White hand. I can use this one. Look, the swagger anti-perspirant 5-pack from Old Spice, which is available at Sam's Club. This is what keeps me going, sets off my fire daily, and protects me at the same time. I'm talking 24/7, lasting protection. All right, white hand, please. Okay, me, you, in the tub. Let's go. Let's go. No hesitation. All right?
It's not that bad now.
Cut this. Get in the tub.
I'm trying. You gotta go gradual.
Okay. The reception from your other sisters is what? How do they feel?
It's awesome. We all hooped, and we all hooped D1 high level.
Wow. So, like, why? What? Who? Was it mom? Was it dad?
No.
Who said it
so
all?
We always say that, like, we fell into basketball and fell in love with it. I want you to guess my first sport.
The thing where you stick your fist in the mud.
Why? Is this because I'm African?
Is this because I'm African? No, because you got big hands.
Okay, I do have big
hands. All right. What is it? What's your first sport?
Gymnastics.
Get the f*** out of here.
It was gymnastics, y'all. And so I knew I was not destined for success because you know those uneven bars?
Yes.
So I would never be able to make it all the way around because my butt would be hitting the floor and my legs are so long. I never got the traction. You would be flying around, but I could never make it around. You
first
know what I'm saying?
First of all, I made two junior Olympic gymnastics.
You would fly around. Okay, yeah.
Two.
You are built like a gymnast, though.
Well, that's just because of my genetics. I come from a family of great builds.
Oh, yeah. What's happening here, Kevin?
Okay, what do you mean what's happening? It's time to get cold. That's what's happening.
Oh, no.
That's what's time. I told you it's going to get colder. Things are going to get real.
Long story short, we were in gymnastics. My mom's friend came in and watched us and was like, what are you doing? Put him into basketball. And the first practice we went to, my older sister and I give a lot of credit to my older sister. We were wearing jean shorts, jorts. I was like 9. My older sister was about 10 or 11. I'm very competitive. So I was like, I'm not going to do anything I'm not good at. So I went to the bathroom and hid there the whole practice.
Really?
My sister, NECA, stayed through it. And that first year, she taught me how to play the game after going to practice. We'd come home and she's like, Chiney, this is what I learned.
It truly is a sport that it was self.
Yeah, we fell into
you,
it.
You became aware, and it was like, oh my God, this is the best thing ever.
And we didn't have those backyard battles that everyone thinks about. I always say for us, especially as women, what has been so powerful is that us learning the game was collaborative, not competitive.
That's actually refreshing to hear. Yep. I mean, me and my brother, we were extremely competitive. I love him.
Long as it's healthy.
But my big brother ain't shit. You already know what it is. You already know what it is over here, big bro. That changed a long time ago. Because I remember every day that I lost and you made me touch that dead mouse. We love each other. We do. Chiney, I'm sorry, I went off on a little tangent. You up? Chiney, I said, get your up. If I hit you with this guy, don't embarrass me. Get up. Get your up. Yeah.
You were just talking.
No, you was in shock. All right, you're in the league for, 10 years? How long have you been in the league?
I'm like 9.
9?
Mm-hmm.
Still playing, though.
Yes.
You're still an active player.
Correct.
But while being an active player, you decided to embark in the world of journalism.
Yes.
And you're not only in the world, you've landed yourself a job on the biggest sports platform in the world.
Make the sound.
Da-na-na. Da-na-na.
Nailed it.
Right? Do your sisters and friends, are they all aware of the history that you're making as being a black woman on that stage?
I think the inner circle understands, I guess you can say, my journey. A lot of it was taking injury because I've been injured twice, mm-hmm. so I'm used to these things, mm-hmm. And turning that injury, that adversity, into opportunity, mm-hmm. because that's how I got my first broadcast job. And so that turned into, you know, working in studio for the Pac-12 Network and getting to ESPN, calling women's basketball games, and then transitioning into the NBA, and then now, like, being one of the premier faces of hoops, which is awesome.
You really are. Like, you are a face that is associated now with real knowledge and understanding of the game.
I appreciate
your breakdowns. I'm dead serious. Your breakdowns.
Oh, you like the
breakdowns? Of the players, of the individuals. Like, it's not fanfare based.
It's real life.
Yes.
Because I experienced that. I walked through that, mm-hmm. and I appreciate that. And I think as a woman, I've had to take that approach. Mm-hmm. I always tell people that they see you before they hear you.
Mm-hmm.
They judge you before they know you.
Mm-hmm.
If we make a mistake, that mistake is magnified.
Mm-hmm.
So that pressure of being a woman, talking in, you know, primarily on the NBA, a male sport, and then also just being a woman of color and what that represents, knowing that if we do it well, next thing you know, there are more opportunities for others,
mm-hmm.
that's what helped build me into who I am today.
For a lot of athletes, it's like, what happens after the game, right? And some do find success in discovery, right?
Yeah.
Some do find. Okay, we gotta go deeper in the tub. Okay, you guys are actually doing a good job.
Like, do we?
You remove the stool so we can go deeper in the tub.
Get in tone.
Okay.
This is the hardest part as an athlete, though.
Getting in the tub.
Like, it's the nipple line.
Yes, right here.
It's the nipple line. That's where like life or death happens.
I never pass it.
Sit here.
No shot.
No.
Okay, hold on. Get your back.
Duncan, go.
You're getting shot.
Come on.
All right.
Yeah.
You proud of yourself? Assault is what we call that around here. And Ben, why do you have on a number 130?
Leave him alone.
Oh, that's just that 3 expanded.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay, Bam. I'm sorry. The 3 looks like 2 big O's. I'm sorry.
Oh,
you just snorted. I just heard you. Okay, all right. While doing what you do, you have now found a career in the thing after.
Yeah.
I think that it doesn't get better than that.
Amen.
Think that's truly, okay, that's it. What, Go.
It's empty.
Go over there, man.
It's empty.
Go. No, you're not putting a bucket. Go. That's enough. Get off. Get. Daryl, get him back over there. No, take him back over there. Take him back. Hurry up, Daryl. Daryl, hurry up.
Like, should we take it off so he can see you?
No. Bam, watch your step. Watch the steps.
No. Not this way.
Journalism at a high level.
That is not journalism.
All right. Are you at a point now with the game where you're like, I have a certain amount of years left that I want
to
give?
So my ultimate goal is to win a championship with my sister.
I love it.
So no matter where that is, like, that is a goal.
Within the conversation of the WNBA, we can't get out of here without talking about the constant conversation for equality and equal opportunities, right? Trying to close that gap as much as they possibly can.
A lot of times when people talk about the WNBA, they talk about it from their lens of what these stereotypes are.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning, oh, well, y'all don't make money, or y'all aren't successful. Well, we are the longest standing professional women's sports league, 25 years. And yes, we get a lot of support from the NBA, but we are trying to separate ourselves and create this ecosystem that is viable,
mm-hmm.
you know? And my mom always says, like, tiny drops of water make a mighty ocean.
Absolutely.
And so we've been making these tiny drops to really change the tide for women in sport,
mm-hmm.
to guarantee maternity leave, to help family planning, to make sure that when you're done playing, you're taken care of and you have mm-hmm. insurance and 401k. We accomplished a lot of the baseline things, the foundational things, for us to thrive in mm-hmm. the years to come. And
oh, they want the same pay as LeBron and KD. That's never been the fight. That's never been the conversation.
That's just what always gets magnified and derails the conversation.
Exactly. We don't get out of here without playing a game. Being that you're now in the world of journalism, broadcasting, I felt maybe that's what you and I should do.
Okay.
Okay? What we're gonna do, bam, take the bucket off your head.
Okay.
Okay.
I got you.
Okay.
There you are.
All right, guys, you're gonna play a game of basketball, all right? Just try to look like you know what you're doing to give us something to commentate on. Wow, hey, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Kevin Hart, and we are here on Coldest Balls. Chiney, say hello to the people.
Yes, welcome to the Coldest Balls Invitational. I'm your girl, Chiney Ogwumike, here with some guy, and we're excited. We've got a great matchup for you tonight.
That's right. Not too many people get born with two left feet and two left arms.
True.
But these two guys did. We got Bam and Daryl going head to head, one-on-one. Daryl, you get the ball first.
All right, this is gonna be difficult for Daryl. He's sizing up his competition.
Wow.
He's got a nice handle.
Wow. Okay.
You got a Euro step. Daryl.
Still.
Comes out of the gate.
Still.
Time. Score is what?
I don't know if that was two or three. Reminded me of the time when Michael Jordan dunked on Larry Bird and Larry punched him in the face. All right,
well,
so that's what happened.
You got the colors right.
All
good
right.
job.
There we go. Oh, Daryl seems to be pumped up still.
Okay.
Bam set.
Off the glass!
It comes down to this right here.
It's 1-1, the final shot. Next score.
Daryl, look at Daryl showing moves of finesse. Oh my God.
Daryl, we've got a sidestep.
Game over!
Oh
God.
Oh gosh. He pulled a Giannis.
We've
seen
that.
Threw the ladder.
Yes. He threw a ladder like Giannis. We've seen this before.
We have.
Oh my God. If you can't control your temper, you can't control your fate. If you can't control your fate, you can't get out the gate. Ladies and gentlemen,
hey,
I'm Kevin Hart, and I don't do this by myself, but I should. I should.
No, you shouldn't.
I should. Chiney, thank you so much
for
coming on the show. No, you're fun. And we are really, really proud of you and all that you've done. Oh, God. He's pissed.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I don't blame him.
Take care of the jersey, though.
Hey, I tell you what, losers don't stay, they leave. Everybody knows that. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you next time on Coldest Balls. Wow. Good for you, Daryl. Yeah, celebrate it.
You
sure? Chiney, good job.
Thank you.
I mean,
this
really,
was fun.
It's because I didn't know what to expect. I was like, this is going to be But you came
it's
in
never.
Here. You came in here hot.
You know how it is,
right? And you knocked it out the park.